Welcome to another Savage OS development podcast. And this time around, yeah, I want to implement the rest of the multi-select bar in FileCat. So it is basically part 4 now of my little development podcast video. So we have the multi-select bar here with all the buttons. As you can see, we have the move function, so cut. We have copy and we have cancel. What is missing right now is delete, so I have to somehow implement a delete function. Of course, there's already a delete function. The only thing that I need to do is just simply have an option to iterate through all the marked files and delete them. So to do this, first of all, we have to think what's the easiest thing to do here first. The easiest thing to do here is, of course, taking a look at how to do this optically. So if I want to delete all the files, I want to have some kind of countdown banner that just like let me show you this in here. So if I want to delete this file, you can see if I hit delete, you have this banner here. And this is for this particular file. But if I have multiple files that I selected, what I want to do is have a global banner that's running on top here that will remove all the files in a few seconds then. So to do this, we will basically use this function here. So what I want to do is go to file item delegates and take a look at the remove function. And you can see here there's a removal component create object BG delegate. So let's search for the removal component. Where we have it, remove item, ID remove on cancel destroy. Okay, so this is what we want to have, but we don't want a remove item. I think we want to have some kind of remove timer. I'm not sure how it's called. Let's take a look at here. Forgot already because it's not so much what I'm using all the time. Remorse pop-up it's called, or remorse pom, just remorse. Let's take a look what this is about. It's just called remorse. Where is this remorse thing here? Remorse item action. And there's a pop-up action as well. You know what? I think I want to use this remorse pop-up because this works like this. And this code is the one that I will use. We'll just call it remorse maybe. And what it will do is like remorse execute. And yeah, this is I think what I will do. So let's just copy this or remorse item. Remorse pop-up makes more sense, I think. And we have to copy it somewhere in our open dialog. So I will go down here. Needs to be here underneath the multi-select bar, and it will be called remorse. Yeah, I think we can call it. We can call it remorse. Let's see what we'll do with this remorse pop-up and remorse remove. Maybe let's call it like this. And just like another example, we will remorse execute something. On clicked, there's remorse execute clearing. And what we will do here is copy this as well, and we will put it in our multi-select bar. And what we will do here is on clicked, we will say remorse remove execute removing files. Of course, we could now also. We could do it a bit better, just like we did on where is it? where we have had a count. We put the clipboard count inside of the pop-up so it knows how many files we are removing. So what we'll do here as well, here it is, clipboard count, QSTR. Also, what we do is removing okay, we have to do it a little bit differently like this. No, we couldn't. I think we can. That's an elegant way to do this here with QSTR, I think. Just like if you want to use. Where am I now in the. Here. QS translate, which is QSTR, custom context, and then greeting. QSTR. Haha, so here's a documentation, QSTR, string, source text, string, and then an int, string ID, int. Let's take a look here. Return the translated version of the source text, optionally based on a disambiguation string, and disambiguation string, and value of end strings containing plurals. Otherwise, return source text itself if no appropriate translation string is available. If the same source text is used in different roles within the same translation context, an additional string may be passed for the disambiguation. What I want to find out is if I can give it an just a simple variable inside of the translation. I'm not seeing it right now. Let's search online. QSTR. Maybe there's something online, how to do this. Someone asking the same question. So this is how development goes, usually. So how can I use QSTR with variables? And C++ file. This is not what I was searching for. There's a documentation about internationalization in general. So I can add context as well for your translations. Might be also very interesting if you want to translate stuff. And then you have the disambiguous identical text. So here you have the context of this translation as well. And here you have the file argument. Use something to insert parameters into a string. This is exactly what I was searching for. And here's an example on how it's done. So this is basically how we will do it as well. So we have a and then we have an arc. Okay. So not so hard. Let's see. Where are we? So we add it here. And then arc, yeah. Yeah, dot arc. And in arc we put in the clipboard count. Okay, and the function will be then interesting enough, we have to remove all the stuff. So what we will do is either create a remove function directly here, or create a new remove function and just call it from here. Maybe it makes more sense to have a remove function not here but in open dialog. Or do we have a remove function here? No, we have it in the file item delegate. There we have a remove function. Search the whole document. There we have a remove function. It'll create because it's creating a here the remove function will create and here the removal execute is calling calling this thing deleting. So maybe we will in our just to be consistent here we'll also call it deleting. And yeah, what we'll do now is then yeah, I think it makes more sense to have a function here somewhere, remove files. Now we can just for this one time we can just put it in here, and then what I like to do is make it so a little bit more readable, I think. Control I, by the way, the one that you use for automatic indentation level thingy, what I did here, so it will auto format stuff. So what I will do right now is just put in the function for removing stuff. What I basically have to do is just take a look where's the paste function in open dialog. Paste function is going through the clipboard count and then doing the copy process, and we will basically what we'll do is just simply copy this completely, even with the reset watcher. We don't need a watcher for this thing. We will copy this and go into multi select bar and paste it in here. Let it reformat. Okay. So for the clipboard, we just simply say deleting here. This is the delete function. FM has also a function for removing stuff. No, it's not called delete later. It's called remove deer or remove in general. Let's take a look what I have in my FM helper here. It comes to remove. We have remove deer, remove recursively. We don't have a remove function in general, so that means let's take a look at the remove function here. It will check if a file is deer, and if it is a deer, it will call the remove deer. Otherwise, it will call the normal remove function. What's the difference of remove deer? Remove recursively. I'm not sure if this makes sense. Do we have to have this distinguish? Let's search for QD. What if it is a file and not a directory? Where do you have the remove recursively? Turns true if successful. Otherwise, if a file or directory cannot be removed, remove recursively keeps going and blah blah blah. So. So we really have to check if the URL is a directory or a file, because we have either qfile or we have qdir. What I could do, of course, is write a function here in C++ that just is called remove, so the remove function, and it will distinguish between remove and it's a directory or a file in C++. But as we already have the file is the option here, and we can, I think, also check here is file. I have to take a look what this is file does. Returns true if the object points to a file or symbolic links to a file. Returns false if the object points to something which isn't a file, such as a directory. So yeah, so we have an option to check just simply if is file here, and this is what I think I want to do now, so I don't need to implement something fancy new. So we have the source here. Maybe I do it a bit. A bit easier here by introducing a new easy to use variable copath, which will be set to the source, and then what I will do is just simply check if is file takes a URL here, then we will do the normal remove function. Remove this, the normal remove function of QPath, and it will also work for ceilings, and else we just think that if it isn't a file, then it needs to be a directory. There's no other documentation. Is I think was clear on this, wasn't it? Where is it? This file documentation returns true if the object points to a file or is a symbolic link to a file. So it's a file. Returns false if the object points to something which isn't a file, such a directory. So there are only two possible ways: it's a directory or is it is a file. So we can write else here, and then we will use the fm remove the fm remove dir function here for the path. Okay, let's put the semicolons in here. We have a lock, we have a clipboard clear because we want to clear the clipboard, of course, and we have a refresh just in case that it's not refreshing, especially in multiple files. Our file folder model. Yeah, if I'm not completely mistaken, this looks good to me. So we will just hit OK and start. And yeah, what I need to test now, let's see, I have to close this down. What I have to test now is, of course, if it is working with multiple files and also mixed content like files and folders. So let me go to here and we have here a few documents, but let's just for the sake of it touch a few documents here again. Of course not here. Yes. Memo. And let's touch a few documents here, and what we will do as well is having a test directory as well. So what I want to do now is remove all those four files. So select here and hit this, and it's not working. Oh, that's interesting. So it removed all the stuff, apparently. But I didn't see the action. It should be on top here, which is interesting. Remorse remove. It is called remorse remove, if I'm not completely mistaken. Open file, open dialog. Bottom. Remorse pop up. Remorse remove. Yeah, exactly. What do we have as options here? Should we? It turns if it's running, but if I'm executing it. Exactly. This is a specific text. Once it does, call back on trigger, handle this before action. Yeah. So where's the issue? Yeah, I don't see the issue. Remorse pop-up is not working anymore. Maybe it's broken. I don't know. Let's close this down. Let's start this again. Let's create our folder and test thingy again. It's just a pain that the file model has a problem when you add too much stuff. It will not refresh. Okay, let's do this again. So you select, just maybe it was a one-time glitch. So now, it's running here. So I didn't see it. So deleting files, and it removed all the files. Okay, it's working. I just didn't notice it. Okay, it happens sometimes. So, one thing that we need to do is just hiding the multi-select bar, of course. Multi-select bar, multi-select equals false, so you have to do this as well. I did it before. So, I want to hide it automatically. So this would work then as well, I guess. Let's just push it here and see. Test once again. What I want to test out is, of course, if the folder stuff is also working with a folder with files inside. So let's, while this is compiling and doing stuff, let's create a folder. Let's go into test folder and stuff there as well. So we have the doc 1, 2, 3, we have a test folder with doc 1, 2, 3, and now I want to remove all of these files. Just this two, maybe. Deleting 3 files and 3, 2, 1, go. So we have doc 3, we still have a test folder with doc 1, 2, and 3. So something went wrong. What is it? What went wrong? Do we have an error message here? We don't have an error message. We have deleting home with name test, okay, and deleting doc1 with doc1 test. And doc2 is the. Okay, the JSON pass error, but why is this still here? Is this really still here? Or is it just. It's still here because I was in the test folder with my terminal. Probably. So let's do this again. It should then give an error, print out an error. This is something I need to take care of as well. So let's try it again. No, it doesn't work. So again, let's test. All the files are in there. So we have a problem with it not giving me any error message. and not removing the directory that I want to remove. Remove dircor path. That's correct, yeah. We have a remove. And we have a remove dir, which removes recursively the directory with all the files inside. And I'm not completely mistaken. Removes the directory including all its contents. Yes, exactly. This is what we want to have. So now the question is, why isn't it removing this? What we could do is, of course, put in here, not here, maybe here, lock again, control lock, directory and contents, and close the bracket here. That's bad coding style, but it basically what should work then. It should tell me that it's trying to remove the yeah. Let's see if it works or not. In theory it should work because it just simply is checking if the current path is a file, and if it is a file it should call remove, and if it's not a file then it's a directory, it should call fm remove dir, which should remove everything. And this needs to work in my opinion. Yeah, it's telling me removing directory and contents. So it is calling the definitely the right thing. So the check for if it is a can make this check is working for if it is a file or not, but somehow it is not removing the stuff. Question is now why. This is really interesting. So let's see, fm helper. It's just a void for remove dir, so this is the reason why we don't get any error message. But we're calling the same, wait a second, we're calling the same function in files and delegate when we hit delete, aren't we? Delete, maybe delete, remove. There's remove function. Remove execute. Genau, remove to del path, which is file path, yes. We are also calling this exact same function. So let's try this then. This needs to fail as well if this is working. Yes, it's also failing and has all the files inside. So this means our remove dir function is wrong. What the f? This was working fine in QDIR. Documentation is clearly on the remove recursively. Stance mode, remove all the file, keeps going, and remove and release as many files as subdirectory as possible, then returns for. Maybe this directory cannot be removed because it is. Or the files cannot be removed because they. It doesn't make any sense. It's owned by root. Okay. Let's do it a different way. Let's test it a different way. And so error handling is not in here, which is, I think, a problem. Let's see if I can put it in here easily. It will return a bool, either true or false. So I can make it a bool here. Then in theory, because if it is fast enough without blocking, especially when remove deer is called, otherwise I need to put it in an extra thread. This is probably the reason why I put it in a void here, because I was lazy. I didn't want to put it in a bool. No. Let's just Azuto the Nemo and then mkdir test and touch the doc 1, 2, 3 files dot text in the test. So it's not refreshing anything. So there we have our test with our doc files, and now let's see again the select and remove function here. Yeah, now the stuff is gone. So the problem was really that we didn't have any writes to remove files, which is interesting because it was removing files without any problems in the home directory that I created before. That I touched there. Ah, it doesn't make any sense, but okay. So we have this right now, so what I would do is just go to desktop 3 and downloads work safefish filecat and take a look at, which is also a very important part which I didn't do in my last parts, is take a look at the diff. And yeah, you can see there's also the translation done for various translation files. So I think this diff looks good, and it's small enough so I can say implemented remove function. Git add, git commit, implement function for multi-select bar, and I can push it if I'd like to. Usually I like to push stuff because you never know when your hard drive or SSD fails. So okay, I will push it later. What I need to do, I could, it's hard to, we have to do the same construct as with CP file. And using a qfuture qt concurrent like thing here for the remove function as well to make it run in the background and then send a signal when the remove function, when the remove is done or not. And if it is not done, it will give you an error message or not. So this is one thing that needs to be done for the remove function as well, I think. Maybe not the remove one file function, but the remove deer function in the future. So this is something I should put on my to-do list when it comes to this. But now I think we have everything so much integrated here. So we have the select option, we have cut, copy and remove. And yeah, this looks fine, I think, to me. For all the file actions going on. So let me try to remove those files here and see if it works inside of a folder as well. It works inside of a folder as well, and when I touch stuff here again and mark it, it will not interfere with, it will not try to remove other stuff, will it? 3, 2, 1. No, it's trying only to remove the doc1 text and doc. Okay, yeah, I think we are done with this multi-select bar so far. And I hope you enjoyed this little video demonstration, this little podcast. And if you like, subscribe, give it a thumbs up. Share the video as well with other people that might find this interesting. And yeah, thanks for watching.